So the first location is the liver. It will occur inside the liver, and second location is the red blood cells. So let's discuss about the symptoms of the malaria. So here are some symptoms of malaria, like you can feel fever, you have some types of fatigue, you will feel tired, vomiting, and you will feel headache. And the symptoms appear after 10 to 15 days after the mosquito bite. Diagnosis tests are available, like you will first of all done your blood test, and you will do antigen detecting test, and after that you can easily diagnose that whether a person has malaria or not. There are some preventive measures, like you can use mosquito net in order to prevent yourself from malaria, and also you can use insect repellents. And the medication for this malaria are the anti-malarial drugs which are available, and the most important drug is quinine. Quinine is naturally present in a crude drug which is cinchona bark. So cinchona is a tree, and the bark of that tree contain quinine, which act as an anti-malarial agent, and it will treat you from the malaria. Now, after discussing the whole information about the malaria, I want to share about the life cycle of malarial parasite. I want to share both of these cycles and how they are occurring inside the human, as inside the mosquito, as well as inside the man, liver, and the red blood cells. So this diagram is representing. So these are all the things which are happening inside the human, and these are all the things which are happening inside the mosquito. So let's start from that point. First of all, you have to remember, whenever I have written M and circle it, it means it is a mosquito. So first of all, let's suppose that this human being is infected with malaria. Now a mosquito of female Anopheles mosquito will bite that person which is already affected with malaria. Now the person which is affected with malaria contains some types of gametocytes. These gametocytes may be male and female gametocytes. So these male and female gametocytes will enter into the mosquito. Now these gametocytes are inside this mosquito. Now what will going to be happen? These gametocytes will fuse with each other. Like that, in the diagram it's represented here, the male and female gametocyte will fuse and a zygote will form. So here is the zygote is represented. So this zygote will enter into the gut of that mosquito. So as you know, gut has various types of enzyme in it. So this zygote will form a membrane around itself in order to protect it from the harsh environment. And then after that, severe kind of divisions will occur inside this zygote, and various kind of sporozoites will develop into it. Like in the diagram is here, it is shown that in zygote, the mitotic division occur and various kind of sporozoites are formed. Now after that, this cell will burst and various kind of sporozoite will release. Now these sporozoite will enter into the So now here you can see these sporozoites are released. Now these sporozoites will enter into the saliva of that mosquito. So now these sporozoites are in the saliva of mosquito. Now this mosquito again bite to a person which is healthy. Okay? Now this mosquito is infected. Now it is going to infect a healthy person. So now whenever this mosquito infected, it injects sporozoites into the human body. Let's suppose this is a human body and sporozoite is entered into it. This sporozoite will enter into the blood and directly goes into the liver. So this is the liver of a human and this is the healthy liver. Now sporozoite will enter into it. After that, you can see here I have draw a hepatic cell. This is a hepatic cell, and this sporozoite will enter into this hepatic cell. So hepatic cell is the liver cell. Now here this sporozoite will divide rapidly into the mitotic division and rapidly divide, and after that it will form various kind of metrozoites. So here are the metrozoites. Now this cell is going to be burst and these metrozoites are released. Now at the last step, these metrozoites will produce into gametocytes. Into what? gametocytes. And then again, this gametocyte will be taken up by the mosquito, which is the healthy mosquito, and this person will be infected with malaria. So this is the life cycle which repeated after, and the malaria is separated out. So in the human, I only have explained about the sporozoite entering into the liver, but sporozoite also enter into the red blood cell. Let's suppose this is a red blood cell, and your sporozoite from here enter into this red blood cell. So first it formed a ring-like structure, then after that it will develop and undergo into various kind of mitotic divisions. It will develop into this like structure, then after another mitotic division, it produces different kinds of metazoites inside the red blood cell. And after the red blood cell, after the 42 hours, this red blood cell is going to burst like that. Now this red blood cell is burst, it will open it out, and various kind of metazoites will release into the blood. So then these metazoites will damage the other red blood cells which are in the surroundings, and then this cycle is repeated. After the 72 hours, the next red blood cell burst it out and release various kind of metazoites. So this cycle will repeat it out, and the malaria will happen. Okay, so this was all about the malaria's lecture. I hope that you will understand this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to this channel and like my videos, and also press the bell icon in order to get the notification of all the videos which I have uploaded. So thank you so much for liking this channel, for subscribing me. Meet you soon in the next lecture. Till up, Allah Hafiz.